Dear students, now let us do problems on surface tension. You know the formula for surface energy, additional potential energy associated with the surface molecules divided by the surface area. That is, surface energy is defined as additional potential energy per unit area. That is why we have this formula. And to produce this additional potential energy, you have to do some work. So this is equal to work done. Work done is stored as additional potential energy and the surface area as it is. Now you can write work done W, surface area A, or W is equal to S into A. Similarly, delta W is equal to S into delta A. Delta A represents increase in surface area. This represents work done. So we will be using these formulas while solving the problems. Calculate the work done in blowing a soap bubble of radius 2 cm. Surface tension of soap solution is 7 into 10 power minus 2 newton per meter. So calculate the work done. Work done is asked. Radius is given. 2 cm. Surface tension is given. S means the surface energy as well as surface tension. 7 into 10 power minus 2 newton per meter. See here, the formula related to work done is W is equal to S into A. For soap bubble has two surfaces, therefore its surface area is 2 into 4 pi r square. Now substituting this here, we get the answer. Find the radius of a soap bubble if 44 into 10 power minus 6 joules of work is done in blowing the soap bubble. Surface tension is given. Work done is equal to S into A. For soap bubble, soap bubble has two surfaces, therefore A is equal to 2 into 4 pi r square. Substituting here, from this or so, substituting the values, you can get the answer. The answer is 0.05 meter. A soap bubble is blown to a radius of 3 cm. If it is to be further blown to a radius of 4 cm, what is the work done? So, noting the data, R1 is equal to 3 cm, R2 is equal to 4 cm. So, initially, its a surface area was, for soap bubble, the surface area is 8 pi r square. So, A1 is equal to 8 pi R1 square, A2 is equal to 8 pi R2 square. So, A2 minus A1 is equal to 8 pi R2 square minus R1 square. So, that is delta A. So, now the work done. Work done. Is equal to S into delta A. Surface tension into 8 pi R2 square minus R1 square. So here surface tension of soap bubble is 7 into 10 power minus 2 into 8 pi into R2 4 square minus 3 square. So centimeter square means centi means 10 power minus 2 meter whole square. So we get the answer 538.56 into 10 power minus 6 joules. If work done by an agent to form a bubble of radius R is W, then how much energy is required to increase its radius to R? Initial radius R, final radius 2R. So, initial work W, how much energy is required? W2 is equal to how much? Delta W is equal to S into delta A. We know that for a bubble, surface area is 2 into 4 pi r square. That is 8 pi r square. Now, A1 is equal to 8 pi r1 r square. 8 pi r square. A2 is equal to 8 pi 2 r whole square. Second time. R square. Now, delta A. So, here delta W means W2 minus W1. S into delta A means A2 minus A1. W2 we don't know. W1 is W. S into A2 and A1. 32 pi r square minus 8 pi r square. So here S into we can write this 32 as 4 into 8 pi r square minus 8 pi r square. So s into 4 minus 1 8 pi r square. Here w1 is given, but actually delta w is asked. So here let us keep this as delta w only. So what is asked is delta w, and you are getting 4 minus 1 3 into s into 8 pi r square. This is first equation, suppose. Now w1, see, this is but w is equal to s into a, and s into a is equal to 8 pi r square. Therefore, in place of this, you can write w, substituting 2 in 1, we get delta w is equal to 3 into w, that is 3w. A wire PQ of length 5 cm, which is free to move, is kept on ABCD rectangular frame. When this frame dips in soap solution and raised, find the force F required to keep the wire PQ in equilibrium. So here the slider wire length is given, and that is L is equal to 5 cm, so 0.05 meter, and S value is given, surface tension 4 into 10 power minus 2 newton per meter. So force is asked. We know that surface tension is force by length. So from this we get F is equal to S into 2L. So 4 into 10 power minus 2 into 2 into 4 into 10 power minus 2. Newton. A U-shaped wire is dipped in a soap solution and removed. The thin soap film formed between the wire and the light slider supports a weight of 1.5 into 10 power minus 2 newtons. The length of the slider 30 centimeters. What is surface tension? Here is the soap film. This is the slider. So on the slider, towards the liquid is working Fs. Fs means force due to surface tension, and that is balanced by a weight kept here. Fg means force due to gravitational force or weight. So here, how much weight is given? 1.5 into 10 to the power of minus 2. So F is L is 2L. So we get the answer Newton per meter. A water drop of radius 1 cm is broken up into tiny droplets of water, each of radius 1 mm. Surface tension of water is given. Find number of tiny drops formed. Calculate increase in surface area. Find work done. See, the initial drop, which is bigger, has radius capital R, and each tiny drop is having radius small r. So the volume of the लार्ज ड्रॉप, फोर बाय थ्री पाई आर क्यूब. नाउ हियर वॉल्यूम ऑफ ईच स्मॉल ड्रॉप और ईच टाइनी ड्रॉप, ईच टाइनी ड्रॉप इज फोर बाय थ्री पाई स्मॉल आर क्यूब. नंबर ऑफ टाइनी ड्रॉपलेट, दिस इज नंबर ऑफ टाइनी ड्रॉपलेट्स. लेट द नंबर ऑफ टाइनी ड्रॉपलेट्स बी एन. देन सो ईच ड्रॉपलेट वॉल्यूम इज दिस मच. इफ दिस इज मल्टीप्लाइड बाय द नंबर ऑफ ड्रॉपलेट्स वी गेट द टोटल वॉल्यूम दैट विल बी इक्वल टू दिस. Volume of n droplets is equal to n into 4 by 3 pi r cube. So these two are equal. 1 is equal to 2. So 4 by 3 pi r cube is equal to n into 4 by 3 pi r cube. 4 by 3 pi. Now capital R by small r cube is equal to n. Capital R value how much? Kepler value given. Here it is given. A water drop of radius 1 centimeter. So that is capital R. So given capital R 1 centimeter. Tiny droplets each of radius 1 millimeter. Now here 1 centimeter is equal to 10 millimeters. So here n is equal to capital R 10 small r 1 whole cube. So 1000 droplets are formed. 1000 droplets are formed. This is one answer. Now calculate increase in surface area. Second one, increase in surface area, that is asked. So surface area of large drop 4 pi r square. So this is say A1. Now surface area of each tiny droplet 4 pi r square. Surface area of n tiny droplets, that is, that becomes A2. So one droplet for one droplet 4 pi r square, n droplet n into 4 pi r square. So now change in surface area is nothing but A2 minus A1. आर स्क्वायर। नाउ वी कैन टेक 4 पाई कॉमन एन आर स्क्वायर माइनस आर स्क्वायर। सो एन वैल्यू 1000 1000 into smaller value 1 10 power minus 3 whole square and capital R this is okay minus capital R 10 power minus 3 होल स्क्वायर। राइट, दिस इज अनदर आंसर। थर्ड वन, वर्क डन। So we have two formulas for work done. W is equal to S into A1 this is another form. So we make use of this formula because there is increase in surface area. Surface tension value given 7 into 10 power minus 2 increase in surface area 11.31 into 10 to the power of minus 3. So we get the answer 79.17. A water drop of diameter 2 mm is split into 10 power 9 identical water drops. These are the tiny water drops. Calculate work done. Noting the data, diameter is given. So radius is equal to one mm. So it is split into 10 to the power of 9 identical water droplets. Calculate work say also SW value and given. Now calculate the work done. Now the formula to find work done is S into delta A. So this is the formula. In the previous problem, we calculated delta A 8 minus A1 is equal to 4 pi nR square minus capital R square. Let us remember this as a formula and make use of this. Delta A is equal to 4 pi into nR square minus capital R square. Again here we want small n value, number of tiny droplets. So for that already we got here n is equal to capital R by small r whole cube. So now let us find n value. Capital R is given. But in this problem, tiny droplets radius is not given, smaller value not given. So we cannot make use of this formula. So going to the basics. Volume of large drop is equal to volume of n tiny droplets. वॉल्यूम ऑफ लार्ज ड्रॉप इज 4/3 पाई आर क्यूब एंड वॉल्यूम ऑफ ईच टाइनी ड्रॉपलेट इज पाई आर क्यूब दैट मल्टीप्लाइड बाय एन ड्रॉपलेट्स 4/3 पाई 4/3 पाई गेट्स कैंसिल. नाउ स्मॉल एन से कैपिटल आर बाय स्मॉल आर ओके वी कैन मेक यूज ऑफ दिस कैपिटल आर बाय स्मॉल आर क्यू इज इक्वल टू एन. So in capital R is given, so this is capital R, large diameter. So capital R is given 1 mm, smaller we don't know, number of droplets given 10^9. So this 10^9 can be written as 10^3. Now equating the exponents 1 mm by r becomes equal to 10³. So we can make use of this also, right? And here 10^-3 into millimeter. Milli means 10^-3. 10^-6 meter. Now work done. So now here delta A we want. Delta A is 4π into n r square minus capital R square. So 4π into 10^9 into r value 10^6 square minus capital R value 1 millimeter means 1 10^-3 square. So we get the increase in area like this. मैं now this is delta A. So work done is S into delta A. S is 7.3 into 10^-2. We get this much answer. So this is the answer. What is the work done by an agent in splitting a water drop of radius capillary into n identical droplets. So work done, S into delta A. For delta A we got 4 pi n r square minus n small r square minus capital R square, where small n is capital R by small r cube. Here capital R by small r, this 3 taken this side, n power 1 by 3 it becomes. Or small r is equal to, we can write, see in the given problem small r is not given, so in the work done expression small r should not come, small r must be eliminated. So small r is equal to capital R by n power 1 by 3. So let us substitute this in this place. Substituting this in 1, we get work done is equal to S into 4 pi n r square. R square can be taken common, so we are left with n by n power 2 by 3, so that we get here n power 1 minus 2 by 3. So that we get n power 1 by 3. Here when r square is taken common, here we get minus 1. So this is the answer. So in this, the force due to surface tension is balanced by the additional mass, so that we got such expression previously. On this, let us do some problems.